I'm from Tanzania. East
Tanzania. Yeah. No, I heard that accent there. So how did you find out about me?
I found you. I was going through YouTube, then your video with someone else came down, was in the recommendation section. So through YouTube, that's how I found you.
All right. Now, were you on YouTube searching for a solution to your problem?
Yes.
You've been on YouTube?
Yep.
Okay. Okay, yep. Tell me about the spirit wife.
I have a problems with like lust, masturbation, pornography, and really I've been battling with that for like 8 years now, since I was 10.
Now that means, Jerome, you were molested. You know, you came to awareness, a knowledge of sex. How did that happen?
It was through a tape that we had in the house, and it was a tape that my brother had of like pornography,
mm-hmm.
that I started watching, and you know.
Yeah, Well, what you didn't realize, you were being molested. That's the type of molestation. Mm-hmm. Anytime a child comes into awareness of knowledge of sex, there's a time for all things, and the parent should be the one to teach the children at the right time. But Satan does it prematurely, and when that happens, that is sexual abuse. That is what you call molestation.
Right.
Now have you seen this spirit lady in the dream?
Yeah, I actually did a couple of times. Like, sometimes when I go to sleep, she'll come in. And the thing is, she'll come into like, in like an image of somebody that I actually recognize.
Right.
Yeah, so she'll come in and try to like sleep with me. Like the recent dream I had, she came in and I was laying in bed and she's like crawling over me, on top of me. I'm like, what is it that you want? And she's like, I need you. And I'm like, for what purpose? And she's she says like, for love. That's what she told me. She's like, I need you for love and sex. And I rebuked her, and she goes back into a form of a girl that I actually know. Mm-hmm. And you know, and she leaves.
Mm-hmm. Now you said this all happened in a dream.
Yeah, it happened in a dream, yes.
That's something. Now, you said it's happened in a dream, but I'm listening, and Lord let me know that it was actually happening in reality. But you were dreaming, but it would actually happen as you were dreaming.
Wow.
It was actually happening. Mm-hmm. Jesus, we just thank you for your grace and mercy and setting us free. The good thing is that, Jerome, that you realized that you needed to confess to the wrong ex that you was doing, and you realize you need to be delivered. You refuse to be in denial about it. A lot of God's children are in denial, and that's what the devil wants, so they can never be set free. And unless you want to be free, you're not going to be free.
Oh, I want to be free.
I know. Every time I receive a request, the Holy Spirit lets me know when one is serious and when one is not. This is not a game. Don't complain with me, because I'm not going to play with you. I don't play with the devil. And if you let the devil through you play with God's servant like that, and pretending you want to be delivered when you know you don't, you're really setting yourself up for destruction. So no, don't complain with me. Banish King, don't play. When it comes down to devil, no. Because my Lord and Savior did not play. He do not play. Praise the living God.
Praise God.
Now, also, Jerome, now, was there or is there any family idolatry and witchcraft?
Not that I know of.
Not that you know of. Yeah, there is an ungodly covenant. They're always in an ungodly covenant, idolatry. Whenever we don't serve the Lord, that is idolatry, because we serve a false thing, which is considered to be our God. That is idolatry. And it is considered to be witchcraft. Witchcraft is really a spirit of control. A lot of people look at witchcraft as getting items and putting together and throwing curses and spells on people, but control, trying to control people, trying to control a person is witchcraft. It's witchcraft. Many fathers operate in witchcraft because they try to control their wife, try to control their children, vice versa with the wife and with the children. So control is witchcraft. Well, God gonna set you totally free. Now, what's important, Jerome, is that now, right now, you're not willfully sinning. Now, I'm not talking about maybe you looked at pornography last night. You know, actually, the demons are in your will. They control you. What I'm talking about, you have not given them your total submission, your total will. You know, in doing evil things. That's the difference there. The Son of God children has given demons, actually given demons the legal right to do what they're doing in your life through like their willfully sinning. Like for instance, I had a session on, I think yesterday, young lady, and she was in a relationship with this boy and it was sexual. He called himself a Christian, she called herself a Christian. These things cannot be. They willfully sin. They knew they were doing wrong, but they chose to do it. Why? Actually, because the world doing, and then the people in the church is imitating the world, so they are doing. So you have a lot of God children right in the church. How? Go to church every Saturday or Sunday, whichever day they choose to worship, with their man friend, with their girlfriend, and they are having sex, whether they live together or not. And they're not being corrected by the leader. And they're not going to be corrected by the leader because the leader is full of lust himself. Satan do not cast out Satan. You see, so you can't be in these relationships as though that person is your wife, as though that person is your husband, and doing things that married people do. No. The ideal of girlfriend and boyfriend did not originate from the Holy Spirit. It originated from the devil. To keep a person bound and bound to lust, to sin, operating in sin. You see? So, but that's what's important, that you're not willfully sinning. If you're in such a relationship, you have to be willing from the heart to give that relationship up. You can't expect to keep your deliverance and stay in that relationship like that. Because God was not the one who connected you with that relationship. Okay, how many times you say, well, God showed me. You know, God not going to show you someone you turn up, going to cause you to sin and rebel against him. God's not going to do that. That's Satan. The work of Satan. So you have to be willing to give it over. And then from the heart, be willing to give it up. And then God say, I forgive you, now go and sin no more. And if you're obedient to the Lord, then that door for the enemy cannot be reopened. Okay. Now, after your deliverance, Jerome, you're going to be totally free. What that means is demons, those demons no longer be living in God's house. Your body is his house, his temple. You know that. Your soul, your mind, your will, and your emotion in your body, they're not going to be there. Jesus is going to cast them completely out. The thieves are out of the house. So when a thief is out of a house, you are free to do what you choose to do. Whatever you choose to do, you are free. Just like right now, you're free. You do whatever you want to do. But if thieves is in there, they got you bound, you must do what they want you to do. The demons are spiritual thieves, and Jesus is going to cast them out. So you're going to be free. But outside of your house right now, you know, thieves are everywhere. They look at your house. Trying to look and see if you curse and leave an opening door so they can enter in, but they don't see no opening door. But they're always out there watching. Sometimes they have a destiny come up and try to lift the window up so they make a little noise. You'd be like, who is that? And they'll run away. But the point I'm trying to make, Jerome, is they're not in the house. They are outside trying to get back in. Well, demons, they do that when Jesus cast them out. They're spiritual thieves. And Jesus said, you know, Jesus said this in his word. I'm not quoting it, you know, verbatim, but I'm putting in a link where you can understand. So when Jesus throw out these spiritual thieves, they're on the outside and they're looking around. Oh, I can't find nowhere to go. This person ain't careless. That person not careless. I don't see no open door. Let me go back to Jerome and try to open the door now. Now, he knew I was in there when I was in his dream. He knew that. So all I just have to do is show up in his dream again. And he will believe that I am still in that house. And by believing, he let me right back in. Because he's not receiving what Jesus done for him. Doing by faith in his word. He's going by a manifestation of what he dreamed or what he did not dream to dictate to him that Jesus set me free. Understand what I'm trying to get you to see? Understand? Because they play tricks and games like that. Remember, even in the dream, they're going to try to get in. You just wake up and rebuke and say, oh, no, I reject and rebuke that dream in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, get up. And then you say, Father God, in Jesus' name, thank you for setting me free. My mind, my will, my emotion, body. I glorify you, I magnify you, I praise you, I exalt your holy name forever. I thank you, Lord, and you continue to worship and praise him. As you do that, those devils on the outside go further and further away from you, and they are running. They are literally fleeing from you in horror, in terror, screaming, because you are submitted to God. And you don't think of that dream. You don't speak of that dream. You don't come texting me about that dream. I'm saying that because I got those who keep texting. I tell them these things, and they turn around and text me, not text me, but email me in a lot of details about the dream. I said, Lord, they were disobedient. They're supposed to forget that dream. They had not forgotten. They're telling me every detail, expecting me to read. I said, I'm not reading this junk. It's not worth giving in my thoughts. I said, I'm not reading. So I just reply back and say, such dreams are not worth thinking about. You rebuke them, reject them, no longer think about them, don't talk about them, forget about them, but praise the Lord. Because they're going to keep trying. You know, if a thief gets in one way and he's successful, Jerome, in getting in that one way, and you kick him out, well, when he come back, what area is he going to try to get in that same way? Because that's how I got in the first time. You understand? So the Lord having me to tell you this because those devils going to try to deceive you. That spirit, Satan got many spirit wives. Spirits that call themselves to be wives, call themselves to be husbands. And he's going to send them to try to get in through that same door, which is your dream, to deceive you. And you let them back in because you believe. I won't deliver because I'm still having these dreams, these sex dreams. Oh, no, dear Lord. Holy Spirit will wake you up for you to rebuke that dream. Rebuke that dream and give it to the Holy Ghost. Let him handle that spirit and you worship and you praise the Lord. Okay? And this is after your deliverance. Now, if you've never been truly delivered by an non-appointed servant, that's a totally different circumstance then. If you have those dreams, that means that the thieves are in the house then. But I'm just talking to the ones who have been truly delivered, and the devil keep attacking you through the dream. That's how you handle that situation. Okay? Yeah. Now, if you visit pornography on your computer, you need to get rid of those links, you know. Clear your browser, delete your cookies, because the links are there, and those links serve as a connection, a leeway in which those demons can travel in the spirit realm on that link And every time you go to your computer, if you even go to a spiritual website, you can feel this tremendous pull to go to that pornographic site. That's because the links are still there. Also, you know, girls may have their email addresses. You may have them on Facebook. And you know they don't have godly conversation. You know the reason why you friend them, they friend you. And you know the reason why, because you have them in your contact. You'll get rid of all of that. All of that. Because those are unhealthy relationships. And they will correct good behavior. You know, your men friends, you know, your friends, so-called friends, come around you with ungodly conversation. Hey, you need to protect your hymn. Don't just sit there and listen. You know, if you're not going to say anything and correct them, you need to get up and leave. If they say, man, why are you leaving? Now you tell them, say, man, I can't let such fist in this end of my hymn. Faith in God comes by hearing the word of God. So if faith in God comes by hearing the word of God, well then faith in the devil works comes by hearing the devil works. And I don't want his works getting into my ears, into my hearing, going deep down into my heart. Taking root. If they got no, I'd be sleeping with women, sleeping with men, and I'm going to be honest with you, sleeping with cows and goats and sheep and chickens and all kind of beasts, cats and dogs. You know, people don't believe me when I say it, but it's true. And God gave me confirmation. I was scrolling down my Facebook, came across this feed in a it was a live service in Kenya that I watched, and they're talking Swahili. And my child said, Mama, you act like you understand Swahili. I said, no, but I understand the anointing. And I'd be listening as though I understand Swahili, but I understand the anointing. So it was a young man just like you. Matter of fact, he favored you, but it won't you, though. In Kenya. And he come for deliverance. He gave his testimony. Praise God, Apostle James Nunga, Nino Evangelism Center. Because I've been asking, could you please interpret these things in English so we can understand? So praise God, God had mercy that day, and he began to interpret what he was saying. Well, couldn't have found out this young man was sleeping with cows, chickens, and goats. He was sleeping with animals, over 40. And Satan used him like that. And Satan was tired of him. When Satan got tired of him, Satan sent the spirit of suicide. The spirit of suicide was getting him to kill himself. And that's when he came to the man of God. God set him free. See, Jerome, when you get one sexual demon, you may start out sleeping with a girl. But when you get one sexual demon, they come in a bundle. All of them come, all sexual demons come. There's many sexual demon. Oh man, I forgot to. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Hold up, Jerome. I forgot to plug in my laptop. My battery. My battery. That's several sexual demons. They come in a bundle. I love bundle because you get a great price for a bundle. That's my computer. But anyway, you got immorality. Incubus, succubus, cause immorality, sexual demon. And you guys, then you graduate from that with spirit husband, spirit wife, sexual demon. Anything that deal with sex, you got incest. They include in that bundle. It's a demon. Homosexuality, lesbianism. There are two different demons in the same bundle. And bestiality. It's a sexual demon in the same bundle. So when you get one of those sexual demons, you know what you got? You got them all. That's the reason why. If you're a guy and you sleep around with a girl and keep sleeping around like that, and the Holy Spirit keep wanting you, you don't stop. You start saying, why am I looking at this guy? You wonder why. Because that demon. Start looking at your cousin. Why am I looking at my cousin like that? Why am I looking at my sister, my brother like that? And in America, they love cats and dogs in America. In Africa, you know, they They really have the chickens and the cows and the goats. Here in America, they got cats and dogs. Oh. And you got your cats and dogs, and you find out you're giving them an eye. You say, what is wrong with me? Your eye, what's wrong with me? That sets you a demon then. You'd be surprised on many people with who got cats and dogs in America. That is their sexual partner. Well, again, you get one sexual demon, you got them all. So that's why a man calling himself straight shouldn't get married with the homosexual man. Because he's in the same category. He got the same demon spirit. Okay? The Lord wanted me to share that with you. Now, question is, do you have any body piercing?
Do I have a...
Body piercing?
No, I do not.
How about tattoos? Mm-mm. Okay. Now, do you know that in the physical, you don't have those things? Now, I'm going to ask you, did you ever desire to have a earring in your ear and or a tattoo? You thought about it. Then you said,
I thought about it.
You know why? Because Jerome, in the spirit realm, you have body piercing and you have a tattoo because of those spirits that are in you. Now, if you hadn't called for deliverance, eventually you would have gave in to that spirit wife in getting that piercing and getting that body tattoo. The Lord revealed that to me when I was doing a session, and I all of a sudden the Holy Spirit broke that covenant of body piercing and tattoo covenant. And the girl did not have a piercing physically or a tattoo. But when I commanded that thing to take his ring out, she opened her mouth and took it out of her tongue. But I said, wait a minute, Lord. I said, puck her tongue out. But there was no hole in her tongue. But she had it in the spirit. Couldn't find out she was thinking about getting one. Why? Because she had it in the spirit. So everybody you see with body piercing, and especially if you're a man with a body piercing in the ear, woman with a body piercing in the ear, and it's more than one. And body piercing everywhere. And tattoos. That's because they first had it in the spirit realm. And that covenant never been broken. And that's why they continue to get one. They get one, not just going to get one. Eventually, we'll get the second one, the third one. Like my cousin, when he got that first one, I said, you shouldn't do that. Now he done got over 49. He wouldn't listen to me. And he is demonized. He's demonized. But God can take it. So, Jerome, I'm going to pray for you. I'm going to confront spirit wife. Okay? Because you've never gone through a true deliverance where an anointed and appointed servant of God. A lot of people do deliverance, but God did not appoint them, and God have not anointed them, and that's why they are overlooking the strong man. The only way you bind the strong man, you spoil his good, he said. Because a stronger man had come, that is Jesus Christ. And when God sets you free, Jerome, you share this testimony. Share it with your men friend. And whoever, a lady come trying to approach you sexually, you need to share it with her too. And just wait. If you're not married, just wait on the Lord. He knows when. Okay? Just trust him. Right now, build your intimacy with Jesus Christ. Come to know who you are in him, who he is in you. That is the most important relationship. And that relationship never comes to an end. It lasts forever. One day we're going to be married to him, sitting at that table, marriage supper of the Lamb. That's going to be a great day. Don't you want to be there, Jerome?
I want to be there, yes.
Yes, 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 yes. Marriage supper of the Lamb. Glory to his holy name. Well, it's going to be a powerful time. We're looking forward to that. But in the meantime, you got to stay strong here on earth, stay in our faith and strength in the Lord, and lead others to Christ Jesus. They need to be saved. Don't stop there. Don't stop and say, well, I got them saved and be happy. Yes, but you need to get them also delivered. Because Jesus Christ, he sets our spirit free. He breathed us into his family by his spirit. That's why we say. But we still got the same soul, mind, will, emotion, same body. And that's why he delegated his authority to the body on earth to cast the devil out of the soul realm, out of the body. So don't get just so thrilled about a person being saved. Go on to that next level, your heart. Get them delivered. Then get them filled with the Holy Ghost so that they can find a true pastor to teach and lead them in the things of God so they can spiritually grow. Praise his holy name. So I'm going to go ahead and pray. So Father, in Jesus' name, thank you always for this opportunity and mercy, your grace and mercy to your children, especially to your son, Jerome. I thank you, Lord, because you have a great calling upon his life. You know what you have already chosen him to become, a mighty prophet of God. But it's at your time, not man's time, not at his time, but it's at your time that you will raise him up. And I ask you, Father, don't let him go out prematurely, as many has gone out premature. Father, keep him safe. As you kept the 6,000 prophets safe that your servant Elijah didn't know a thing about, keep him safe in as one in that number until his time. And I thank you, Lord. That's a cry and plea of my heart for you to keep him. But when he go out, he's going out at your time and not at his time or man's time. And I thank you for cleaning your house where he can truthfully, spiritually worship you with all his heart, soul, mind, body, and strength. Thank you, Father. Continue to teach him who he is in your son, Jesus, also who Jesus is in you. And I speak concerning doors. The enemy have closed off doors to Jerome. It's your will for those doors to be open. Father, in Jesus' name, I speak in that atmosphere, in the atmosphere. Open, 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 open. In Jesus' mighty name, I open every door that is your will that the enemy have closed. And I also close those doors. The enemy have opened doors that were never your will. I take my throne in Jesus' name, and I close those doors. And I speak in the atmosphere. Close, 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 close. In Jesus' mighty name. And I seal those doors in and with the blood of Jesus, now to be open or reopened. Father, we thank you for your presence. For you said when there even two of us or more, but you said two, gather in your son's name, you are right here in the midst. You are in the midst with us. You are right here present with us. And I want to say thank you, Father. We could do nothing without you. You also said, whatever we bind and loose on this earth, you are the one who will be binding and loosing in the heavens. And I believe your word, and I thank you. So by faith in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Spirit Wife, you're not no woman. But there's no such thing as gender in the spirit, and you know it. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I command you to manifest. Manifest now. And get out. Pack your loads. You take everything that you put in Jerome. Everything you put in his mind, his will, his emotions, and in his body. Bind them, wrap them around your waist, and for you, get out of God's house. The blood of Jesus commands you to loose him and let him go. Let him go, get out, go where the Father commands you. Holy angels of God, get him. Take him where the Father commands you in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, I call upon you in Jesus' name to search and destroy darkness, those stubborn spirits that are still trying to hold it to Jerome's mind. Burn every stubborn spirit in his mind, in his will, in his emotion, and you set him ablaze. Burn everything that's not you, Holy Ghost. Just ransack his mind. Ransack that mind. Ransack his mind. Ransack his mind. Purify his mind. Wash, rinse, and baptize his mind. Rinse his mind in and with the word of God. The blood of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, continue to ransack his will. Burn those illegal hands in his will. Burn, Holy Ghost. Set them ablaze. Set them all ablaze. Ransack his will by your consuming fire. Holy Ghost fire, wash, rinse. Clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize his will. In and with the blood of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, burn every stubborn spirit that's still trying to cleave and hold on to his emotion. All that is in his emotion that is not of you. You don't walk, talk, act, or react like you. Set them all ablaze. Just burn, burn them off, burn them up. Burn them up, Holy Ghost. Burn, burn in his emotion. Set his emotion ablaze. Burn, burn. Oh, burn those evil, false feelings. Burn every feeling that is not of you. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, burn. Every suggestion, burn, burn, burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, wash, rinse. Clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize his emotions in and with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, burn darkness. They're still trying to cling a hold onto him in his body. Burn those snakes in his eyes. Burn every spirit that comes up out through the window of his eye. Burn lust in his eyes. Burn around his eyes, the front, the back, and the sides of his eyes. Just ransack his eyes by your consuming fire. By the Holy Ghost, burn everything that's not you in his eyes. Just burn. Burn those evil spirits. Burn, burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize his eyes in and with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, burn doors and living in his nose and mouth and ears and hearing. Set his ears and hearing ablaze by your consuming fire. Set his nose and nostrils ablaze by your consuming fire. Set his mouth ablaze by your consuming fire. Burn all that is not in you. Burn, continue to consume. Burn all manner of spirit, even in his throat. Burn up and down in his throat, Holy Ghost. Burn spirits that live in his throat. Burn, Holy Ghost. Set him ablaze. Set him ablaze. Set him ablaze. Burn, burn, burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, wash. Rinse, clean, redeem, wraps, and purify his nose, his mouth, his ears, his ear, his nostrils, even his throat, in and with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, go deep, deep down in his belly. Burn all manner of spirits living comfortably and dormantly in his belly. Burn those snakes and their eggs in his belly. Burn every spirit in his belly. All spirits look like animals, insects, sea creatures. They even take on human appearances, fashion, shapes, and forms, and you set them ablaze. Just ransack his belly. Go deep, deep down in his belly. Everything that's not of you, burn. Burn by your consuming fire. Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Burn, Holy Ghost fire. Burn, 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 burn. Holy Ghost fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, and purify and baptize his belly in and with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, burn those spirits that are living in his penis and in his rectum and all those other organs in his body. And you set them ablaze. Holy Ghost fire, even burn and uproot every plant my heavenly Father has not planted. Set them ablaze by your consuming fire. Burn, Holy Ghost. Ransack his rectum. Burn. Ransack his penis. Burn. Everything that's not of you in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize his rectum pink and all the organs in his body in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, burn up and down his back, up and down his chest, up and down his abdomen. Burn those rings on his finger and toe. Burn that chain around his neck, his ankle, his feet. Burn that evil crown on his head. Burn that evil garment placed on in his body. Burn that spiritual portal. Holy Ghost fire, burn every mark that was made in and on his body, known or unknown to him. Destroy those evil marks, Holy Ghost. Burn those evil morts in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire, burn every body, piercing, and tattoo. Destroy that evil covenant, uproot and destroy by your consuming fire. Burn, burn that tattoo. Burn, 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 burn. Burn those body piercing. Close those holes. Close the holes in the spirit realm. Close them, Holy Ghost, in Jesus' mighty name, for they never shall manifest in this natural realm. Burn those tattoos that was burnt into his spiritual body. Burn, burn, burn by your consuming fire, for they'll never manifest in this natural realm. In Jesus' name, I disconnect him from that ungodly and unholy body piercing and tattoo covenant. In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize his body in and with the blood of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' name, in the spirit realm, I take conscious, I cut and detach it from that ungodly covenant of family, I doctrine. I disconnect him from that evil spirit family, evil spirit marriage. I disconnect him from the evil spirit husband, spirit wife, those spirit children. I disconnect him from every relationship in the spirit realm that Heavenly Father did not connect him to. I disconnect in Jesus' mighty name. Even in this natural realm, every relationship my Father did not connect him to, I disconnect him. For the blood of Jesus disconnects and sets him totally free by his shed blood. Jerome, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, be free. Be free. Mind, be free. Will, be free. Emotions, be free. Dreams, be free. Visions, be free. Businesses, be free. Affairs, be free. Body, be free in Jesus' mighty name. Be free. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for setting your son totally free. Now fill him to overflow with your spirit. Fill his mind, his will, his emotion, his dreams, his visions, his business, his affairs, and fill his body to overflow with your spirit, Father, in Jesus. And Father, I also pray for Jerome. The Holy Ghost, go where he lives and clean his house. Sick, seek, and intent to destroy all darkness in the high place. Go in every corner, crack, and crevice of the room and bedroom and destroy darkness. Destroy darkness who is around the bed, over and under the bed, the front, the foot of the bed, on top of the bed, in between the sheets and the mattress, and destroy darkness. Don't leave no space untouched where he lives. Destroy all darkness in your hiding place. Destroy the arches that are hidden in his place. Destroy those evil arches. Every evil arches that the enemy have attached onto, destroy those evil arches. Go outside the house. Destroy darkness who's around the house, top of the house, the under the house, even underground under the house. Destroy by your consuming fire. Holy Ghost fire, destroy every covenant, contract, agreement written in his name, his family name, that's written on top of the earth, under the earth, underwater, and taken into heavens. Destroy those evil covenant, contracts, and agreements, even the objects of, that belongs to him and his family, that was scattered on top of the earth, buried in the water, buried under the earth, taken into heavens. Destroy those evil objects. That's not where to locate them and destroy. Destroy them, Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name. Destroy those evil powers. Destroy those evil powers. Destroy in Jesus' name. Destroy those evil writings. Destroy those evil writings. Even the pen and paper that is written with, destroy. Destroy those evil tables, those evil altars. Destroy, destroy those altars, Holy Ghost. Destroy in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus. Destroy that evil tree. Destroy the whole tree, for the tree is evil. From the root on up, the tree is evil. Destroy by your consuming fire. Fire the Holy Ghost. Destroy that tree. Destroy that tree. Tree. Destroy that tree in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus. Amen. Amen, Brother Jerome. You are free. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. So just share, as I was missing side prayers, what you was going through, what was happening, what you was experiencing. Share.
I felt something in my stomach. My stomach started to go mad. That's what I was feeling.
You said your stomach was feeling how?
Yeah, my stomach started to get warm and hot.
Amen. Now that spirit snakes was in your stomach. That's lust. Did you have you ever felt something move in your stomach?
No.
No, you've never felt no movement in your stomach. You might have thought it was gas. That's how devils get you sometimes. They say, oh, it's gas. You never felt nothing move? A slight movement.
Yeah, I felt something move.
A slight movement. Yeah, that was Python, spirit snake. That's lust. And the Holy Spirit was setting you free, totally free. Now, in your home in Tanzania, was there a tree in your village, a particular tree in your village? That maybe caught the attention of some people. But there's a tree. You ever notice a tree in your village? A peculiar looking tree, a tree.
There was a lot of trees in my village. Yeah, there was a lot of trees there,
but it's one tree. Did you ever notice anyone, especially going to, maybe sitting under or sleeping under a particular tree? There's a tree in your village that was a very evil tree. Very evil tree in your village. And everybody in that village was connected to that tree. It's a dodge. If you still communicate with your family, especially the older ones, inquire them about a tree in your village. Okay. Yeah. Because a lot of times, you know, family members, you know, things not going the way that they want them to go. They go to witch doctors and they're telling them to get a certain item and take it and bury it. When they got the item, they buried it under that tree, around that tree. So just do some inquiring. You know, and I would advise other Africans who was born in the nation Africa, you know, and even if you were not born in the nation Africa, your family was, don't forget about your country. You need to find out your roots, what they was involved in, because it does matter, because whatever they was involved in, you are connected to it. Regardless how successful you are living in America, it don't matter. You're still connected to that idolatry and that witchcraft covenant that your parents and your grandparents or your great grandparents or your great great grandparents have willfully committed themselves to. And if an anointed appointed servant of Most High God had never disconnected you from that ungodly covenant, idolatry, and witchcraft, it don't matter how big and large you live in America, you're still under that curse. And that's the reason why in most areas of your life, you know, you're not being successful. Look at your children. Your children are wayward. I'm talking to those who got good money in America. But their children are wayward. Their sons are homosexual. Their daughters are lesbians. You know, and they wonder why. That is why. And then some of them, you know, like you know, these spirits are coming to them in a dream. They think it's a dream, but actually the spirit is actually having sex with them in the physical realm. But they make you think that you sleep. So you need to find out your family roots, what they was involved in. Okay? Don't just come here and forget about it, or just don't be another country and forget about it. No, you are still connected. And that's the reason why a lot of them, they leave that country, thinking they go to another country to be successful. Don't realize that all they're doing is relocating the demons that was in them in their own country into another country. You still have those same problems. Do you not know there's not a lot of Africans who will not go back to their home village because they're afraid? But they don't realize those devils are in them. Whether they go back or not, those same devils are still in them. Plus, they got the devils in America, which is pride. That's the strong man, a stronghold of America is pride. Freedom from God, pride from the devil. Okay. So, don't think you come to America or Australia or New Zealand or whatever country or UK and you're going to become successful. No, you're still taking those same demons you had in your home land in Africa with you, plus the devils that are in that country. You got double the trouble. You got double the trouble. And you know, you Africans who are from Africa and you're in the other country, you know I'm telling the truth because you know what you're going through. You have to be delivered. So if you get told to deliver, hey, you can go back home. Enjoy your family. And help your family. God, when you come over here, God bless you. He didn't bless you financially for you. Forget about your family and your country in Africa. No, you help them. You help them physically. And you help them spiritually. You see what I'm saying? That's what God wants to do. There's something now that Africans trying to come to America and Americans trying to go to Africa. You ever noticed that? Praise God. See, now with me, God told me. He said, I called you to the nation of Africa. I thought maybe I'd be traveling this place in Africa, that place. I went to one place in Africa, and that was Nairobi, Kenya, and Masai Mara, Kenya. That's Kenya. I ain't went nowhere else. I would love to go everywhere. But Lord said, I call you to the nation of Africa. And I brought that up to Lord. Lord, I thought you said you called. And I'm getting old now. I said, I thought you said you called the nation of Africa. He said, I did. I said, well, I haven't gone nowhere but to Kenya. He said, Terry, who are you ministering to? And I dropped my head and laughed. I said, Lord, I am ministering to Africans. They are everywhere, in every country, every nation. Right. It is Africans who keep requesting deliverance. I get some American, but I get mainly African. And I'll be quite honest with you. And forgive me if you're American, you get offended at this, but it's the truth. There's a difference when Africans call me because they really are serious about their deliverance. And their faith is ready. But when it's an American, oh, that spirit of pride. I'm ashamed. I don't want to be known. No, I don't have a spirit husband. I don't have a spirit wife. No, you a witch. You wrong. You blah, 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 blah. I keep having sex in a dream. I don't know if this thing worked or not. Just speaking unbelief and doubt. That's what most Americans, not all now, but most Americans have unbelief and doubt. They have unbelief and doubt. But the Africans, oh wow, their faith are real. Their faith are real. The Lord said, whosoever, let them come. So praise the Lord, I get calls from other Asian countries, they are calling. Great is their faith too. They are being delivered. So like great is the faith of other nations than America, people in America, Christians in America. So, you know, I want my African brothers and sisters who want to come to America to live. And I told this brother this when he was in Nairobi, he did now. But he wanted to come, leave his family and come to America. I said, do me a favor, when you come, I said, don't forget about your people in Africa. Don't forget about your people. Let me rewrite strength. Because I know when you come over here, you got, remember now, of course, we are a nation of freedom. That's the angel from God over America is freedom. But also there's an angel over America from Satan. That is pride. That's why you see a lot of Africans that come here to get through a job, even though they're not really being paid what they should pay, but it's more than what they would pay if they was at home. They get full of pride. And that pride really shows when they, if they do go home, they walk with their head up, like, I'm from America. And people, you know, there are people looking on them and praising them because they are living in America. Not realizing that most of them are struggling here in America, trying to make it. But the little they have in America is a lot compared to in their country. So you gotta beware of that spirit of pride. And a fall comes before pride. And you're gonna fall flat on this thing. Don't forget about it. God's a country that you go to, don't forget about your people in your community. God wants you to help them spiritually, and he wants you to help them physically. And when he sets you free, and the Lord Jesus said, go back and help your people, then you have to realize that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. All their witchcraft, their juju, or whatever the witchcraft name they call in your country, they can, no witch doctor cannot harm you. Satan cannot harm you. Satan will breathe out threats, but he cannot harm you. Okay? The Lord wants you to remember that. Now, Jerome, in the future, if you have any questions, you can feel free to contact me and let me know. And then I'll send the email out as soon as possible. All right. So how are you feeling right now? How are you feeling now?
I'm feeling free, yes.
Yeah, you are free. That means those demons are not in you. They're not, no things. Like right now, there's no things in that house. No things is in God's house, not in your mind, with much body on the outside. And you remember to keep that door closed. Whatever avenue they try, the door to try to use to get back in, whether it's through the dream, whether it's through a woman, a man, a man, you stay submitted to God and Holy Spirit with open up your spiritual eyes and let you see Satan traps. He's trying to trap you. And you say, no, in Jesus' name. I say, Holy Ghost, get him, seek him. It's your door. And you start praising and exalting and worshiping your heavenly Father. Keep your mind on the Lord. Regardless of what situation you go through, don't look at that circumstance. Keep your mind on the Lord. The heart remains precious, all the time. Look, things will work itself out. Okay?
I have one more question.
Okay.
So I've been praying. So I can get to know what my calling and my purpose is on earth.
Well, the Lord just told you what your calling is. You are called to be a prophet. God's gonna raise you up as a prophet. Now, you heard my prayer to the Lord, and I seriously meant it, because I see a lot of young men and women who prematurely gone out into that office, and it's not God's time, but man put them in that office based on the gift that they have, very gifted and talented. But it's not their time yet, because you got to go through a spiritual experience. And only the Holy Spirit knows what their spiritual experience is. Okay? So you don't have to, like when the Lord told me, he called me to be an evangelist, I said, okay. I actually never tell nobody, and I didn't dwell on it. What you mean, Lord, evangelist? And I didn't go out evangelizing me. I just continued doing my normal stuff. And what the Holy Spirit did, he gradually raised me up. When he raised me up, he said, now, Terry, it's time. It was 1995 when he told me that. It was 2012 when he sent me out. Long time, man.
Yeah, it is.
In between that time, he had to raise me up. I went through a lot of spiritual experience. A lot of people said, wow, I wish I was a not like evangelist king. Well, you can. But you got to go through your season. You have to allow the Holy Spirit to take you through your season of training, of raising you. It takes time. Now, many times, because of the gift that God gave me inside, many times people try to put me and my husband out there before our time. Pastors tried to put us out there. Prophets tried to put us out there. But I didn't feel nothing from the Lord to go for. I couldn't take men's word. You know, if man said, well, God told me, well, I'm his child. He should tell me too. He will tell you too. But God would never tell me. And we said no. And they rebuke us for it. I said, well, you just have to rebuke me. Because I'm not going forth out when God haven't told me. So he got his time. And I thank God I did. Because I told the Lord, I said, Lord, if I went out then doing what I'm doing now, Satan would have killed me because that darkness would have been in me. And he would have grabbed that darkness in me and killed me. You see? So I had to wait until God's time. So you wait until God's time. You go forth and do what God has you to do now. You know, the call that God has you, it will come to pass at his time. You don't have to dwell on it. You don't have to think about it. You don't have to say, well, is now the time? No, just ponder it. Keep it deep down in your heart. Like Mary did regarding the words of Jesus when he was a baby. And then at God's appointed time, it will come to pass. Because Satan through man gonna try to put you out there too soon. And I want you out there. Maybe being a false prophet. You know, God may have gave you that call. But if you go out before your time, that's what makes you false. False prophet. Because you're not so out.
Gotta wait on God's timing.
Wait on God's time. You gotta go through a spiritual experience. Don't be on Facebook and your name is Prophet Jerome, blah, blah, blah. Don't be doing that. No, it's false prophet because it ain't your time. Anytime you step out before God's time, that's what makes you false. Again, like I said, I see many, they do have that call, but they went out before God's time. But now they are false. They are prophesying. That lying spirit is in them now. That's who operating in them is that lying spirit. Okay? So you continue to do what you do, work, you know, study the word of God, meditate on the word of God, intimacy with Jesus Christ, becoming, you know, who you are in him, who he is in you, a fellowship with the Holy Ghost, just continue to do it, continue to do it. The Holy Ghost can take you through a lot of spiritual experience. And at his time, then he'll say, go for it. Okay. Now that Lord said there may be time he may use you. And you be talking to a person, all of a sudden the Holy Spirit through you begin to prophesy to that person. That's the Holy Spirit. Now, do that mean that you go forth out as a prophet? No. The Holy Ghost is just training you. You said, just be careful with people. You say, oh man, God has to tell you this. Are you a prophet? He said, well, to say. The Lord Jesus is raising me up. Let's put it that way. He's raising me up. He's teaching. He's showing me. I'm learning the things of God. Say that. Okay. And like I said, when the time comes, then he can say, now go forth and out. That's how he did. When he seen you forth, the man said, well, who validated you? Who affirmed you? What man? He said, well, it was Jesus Christ. Yeah, but what human man? Well, it was Jesus Christ. Just so happened in my case, like the Apostle Paul, he didn't use a human man. You see? The Apostle Paul was the only one that was not directly mentored, discipled by Jesus when he walked the earth. But the other disciples were. But Jesus chose him. When it was his time, Jesus sent him out. And the other disciples could not deny it because they saw Jesus working through him. They knew the works of Jesus. They knew they were familiar with the way Jesus worked, and they saw it in Paul. That's how they knew that he had been with Jesus, and Jesus had been with him. All right? Praise God. Well, I have another session. At 12. And again, you know, if you have any questions, email me, and as soon as I'm available, I will respond. Okay.
Okay.
Stay blessed. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you so much for praying for me.
You're welcome. Shalom.
God bless you so much.
You too.
Thank you.